Bing bong! And we are back. Welcome to the CineBoiz podcast, part of the CorkBats podcast network. If you don't know what CorkBats is, be sure to follow them on social media at CorkBats on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok. You can also check out CorkBats on YouTube, which is youtube.com/CorkBats. And of course, be sure to visit CorkBats.com, the actual website. If you go to CorkBats.com, you will see that our review of Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse is up now. It may or may not have gotten a 5 out of 5 Swedish Fish review, which is, that's only other happened one other time. So that's a big deal. You can also check out our Three Big Things podcast, which dropped earlier this week. If you subscribe, you automatically got it, but you can also check it out on the CorkBats YouTube page, where I was joined by Mr. Tom over here, as well as Billy Rock of Do You Like Apple? Shout out, Billy. And then we are the CineBoiz. That came out weird. Got a little bubble in my throat. We're the CineBoiz, the movie, TV, gaming branch of CorkBats. You can keep up with us on social media, at CineBoiz, on Twitter and Instagram, and check it out. We got merch, baby. Go buy our merch.
Show it off. Show it off.
I'm showing it off right now. Merch available now, CorkBats.com/store. Just buy a shirt. I'm wearing it. You see, look, I'm wearing a shirt right now. It's really comfortable. It also makes me look jacked.
Very nice.
Which is always a requirement when I get a t-shirt. But yeah, I'm Kenny. I'm one of the hosts of the CineBoiz podcast. And I am joined by all three of my other hosts today. And it is so good to see them.
Meh.
Well, with that, I think we should start with Kevin. Kevin, how are you?
Oh, shoot. That's a punishment. I'm great.
Let me ask you this, Kevin.
Thanks for asking.
Good. Let me ask you this. What are you big on?
I don't want to be big on Silo again.
But you are.
Can I be big on Silo again?
You can be big on whatever you want to be big on.
Because I am. Because I watched the most recent episode and I'm just like, this show freaking rules. And I want to, it's so good, it's making me want to read books. That's how good it is. That's what I'll say.
Wow.
It's making me want to read the books.
It takes a lot for me to want to read a book.
Yeah, I don't even really know how to read, and I want to read these books.
Have you thought about audiobooks?
I love a good audiobook.
How many?
You know, I suffer from road rage, but audiobooks really calm me down, so.
How many?
It's true.
How many books are in the Silo series? Or is it just one book?
It's three, but it's like a collection of they're like novellas. I would
right.
call them.
So like the first he book released... is a collection of like I think technically 9 different smaller books, and then the third book is like 3, and then the last book's 1.
So and he think, was self published. Yeah. I did some research on this. He was self published. So he just basically started putting out these short stories, like kind of like a monthly thing. I think it was. And people were like, oh, these are good. So he just combined them into some books.
All right.
And the show rules. And you should watch it if you're not watching.
So as someone who is about 75% through the first book, two different experiences.
Okay.
Like, really? Tell me more.
So like overarching, like I feel like they're going to get to the same spot. But the details in the middle are very different.
Oh, so that's even better because that means I can read the book and have a different experience.
So when we did our three big things on it, I said that the common character wasn't in the book. He is in the book. He just hadn't made it to where I was in the book yet. So they've made him a bigger character.
Okay. Well, common rules too. So
it's things like that. Like, this fertility, like the crazy lady, not in the book.
Okay.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
So
would you say
both are good?
Okay. Both are good. And then Kev, but so, you're
hold on one second. Sure. What is she from? Where have I seen her?
Succession.
No, I don't watch that show.
No, not dumb you're show. Not her. Oh. Not her. Not the fixer lady. Who's a male in the book also.
Hollywood.
Did you not watch the newest episode?
Gloria Hildebrand. Who is she?
I've not seen the newest episode. No, I have not.
She looks like she kind of looks like that that lady who is in the office that Aaron like helps when she's in Florida.
Oh yeah,
that's really close.
I know
to
who
her.
You're talking about now.
It's close to her, but I know I have seen her in a movie or a show, and it was driving me nuts.
Well, you know what? There's no way to look this up.
No,
so
no
we probably
I even
shouldn't.
Did, and I couldn't Dude, figure can't. It out.
There's no, we, there's no part.
I was on IMDb for like 10 minutes.
Of movies.
Yeah, I wish there was an internet movie database.
I did that, and I couldn't find it.
I'm sorry, Kev. Well, Kev, here's the thing. I'm glad you're here. And I'm sorry you can't find her on IMDb, but I'm glad you're here. Excited to have you. Let's move on. KC Mob, how you doing?
Howdy!
Are you okay that I call you KC Mob now?
Sure. I mean, I'm still, as we speak, I'm still Nashville Mob.
Still Nashville Mob for four or five more days?
Something like that.
All right. Well, congratulations on the trip back to Central. Well, I guess Nashville is Central Time Zone, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, never mind. Congrats on the move, I guess. What are you big on?
I'm big on Liquid Death.
Oh,
dude,
yeah.
Me too.
I've been hearing a lot about that. Yeah.
Oh, dude. My gosh.
Isn't it just this, water, though?
Shut up, Matt, Tom.
Yeah, you sound like my wife.
I don't know. It's
What's your favorite
one,
flavor?
I feel stupid because it's so expensive. Right now, my favorite flavor is the melon.
I'm a big, is it peach? No, mango chainsaw? Something chainsaw. Yeah, yep. That one rocks my world.
Severed
I like
lime,
the lime one.
Is my favorite.
Yep. Ooh, that's
lime's
a good
great
one.
Too. So, I feel dumb because it's so expensive, but oh my gosh.
Well, here's the thing. The regular, so like the sparkle, like the regular Liquid Death, they have the sparkling and the still mm-hmm. option. I don't ever get those because it's just sparkling water.
Okay.
But they're flavored ones, so the mango flavored. And the lime are so good because they actually use like juice, mm-hmm. a little bit of juice. Which most sparkling waters don't use because they want to say like zero calories, zero. It's like 20
calories. It's
20 calories
yeah. per can.
Yeah. It's, I would say this, it's very big in the secret society that I roll with. I do love the severed lime.
Look, I get it because honestly, I would probably rather have that. It's so good.
I mean, yeah.
It's a masterclass of branding as well. Like they just... I want a little like enamel pin of that skull that I can just pin to my shirt every day as I walk around.
It's a cool can.
On your lapel.
All the cans are freaking cool.
Yeah, I like a good skull.
I do want to get like a so now that I have this office, I do want to get like a mini fridge.
A neon light.
I know it's not gonna happen, but I do want a mini fridge and I wanna fill it with like Liquid Death and then also Zion's energy drinks. I'll save that for my big one. But Mob, glad you're here. Hope the move goes well. Let us know
Liquid
if you need
Death
help.
Sponsor us.
Yeah, Liquid Death, please sponsor
please
us.
Please sponsor
That'd
me.
That'd be awesome.
You know, good luck with the move. Feel free to reach out if you need help.
No.
Okay, cool.
Look, we're to the point in our lives where I'm not asking anyone for help anymore.
No.
Good.
And if you ask me for help, I'm probably gonna say I've got a thing.
Yeah,
what's like the most you're willing to help somebody at this point in like those life things, you know what I mean? Like you got to be family to pick me up from the airport probably at this point. Otherwise
I'll help you move a couch from one level to another. Yeah. Or one room to another. That's but I'm not helping right you move a couch from one dwelling to another.
If you need a second pair of hands to do something within a few hours, I'm your guy. If you need more than one set of hands, like another pair of hands, like two or three pairs of hands over several days, it's not happening.
Yeah, hard.
Several days?
Yeah, like if you're doing like a multi-day move or something like that. Ugh. So
Mob once came over to my apartment for like 5 minutes just to help me move a washer, and it was murderous.
Dude, I would, I'll task rabbit that shit. I'm not moving any appliances. Like, I will hire one person to do that for me.
I'm also not asking my friends at this point to help me out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's wise, but
we're too old and too rich.
Yeah. We got too much money. We got that dank money, bro. Like, you can hire movers. Well, Mob, I'm glad you're here, man. Good to see you. Let's move on to Tom. Tom, how are you?
I'm great.
What are you big on, my man?
Guys, I went and saw Across the Spider-Verse last week, and it is so good. Fantastic. I'd also never seen the first one, so I watched it the night before. Woke up Saturday morning, went straight to the theater, and just it's as good, if not better, maybe, than the original.
I think it's better.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. And, you know, talked enough about it probably in our Three Big Things podcast episode, so go check that out if you haven't listened to it yet. But I just loved the animation. I think it's super cool. And I don't know, there's something about the voice acting in this series that, like, I don't feel like usually you can find in other animated movies. Like, I felt like it was almost like watching actual actors on screen. I don't know, there's something about it that was just a lot more engaging.
Yeah, I mentioned, we didn't talk about this on the Three Big Things podcast, but I did mention it in the review on corkbats.com in regards to the voice acting. I made a big point about Jake Johnson. So Jake Johnson has a really big role in the first film, and he's still in the second one, but it is less of a role. And I'm thinking that the third movie is going to, he'll probably have a bigger role again. But just like the Jake Johnson, but it's not just him. I think it's the whole voice cast of both movies do such a fantastic job of, like, you know, I think in Jake Johnson's case, it's like there's certain things that he says that are so goddamn funny. Like when he's talking about, he's in the original film where he's talking about going back through like his spider story, and he's like, I made some iffy money choices. It's just like, it's so funny.
Don't you think part of that is because you can see, like, Nick Miller saying these things?
Yeah.
Oh, definitely. Like,
Nick Miller, Spider-Man. Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. Well, yeah, Tom, glad you're here. Check out Across the Spider-Verse. Like, we cannot recommend it more. It's so good. Probably the movie of the summer when it's all said and done. Maybe Barbie will be, though. I can't wait till July 21st. That's going to be a big day. Well, cool. Guys, glad you're here. I'm here as well, Kenny. One of the co-hosts of the CineBoiz podcast. I'm going to go ahead and tell you what I'm big on. It's also drink related. It kind of just stirred up in my head when we were talking about Liquid Death. Zions energy drinks. And here's why. One, they're cheap. They're less than $2. And you get a 12, 16-ounce can of Zions. There's less caffeine than Red Bull, but there's still enough to give you a little bit of energy. Plus L-theanine. I don't know how you pronounce it. But it's doesn't make you jittery, but it gives you energy. And here's the big kicker. I usually have one on like Friday or Saturday night when it's gaming night, and I can still go to sleep without any problems, and I can have it at like 9 or 10 at night. So
nice.
I don't know, and they have some good flavors. Fuji apple is my favorite. So if you haven't tried Zions energy drink, one, Zions sponsor us, two, go check it out.
We're big on the liquids.
Big on liquids today.
This is a pro liquid podcast.
Are Fuji apples different than like your every other day apple?
You know, I would assume so, but there are many different types of apples.
Correct.
Which I didn't know.
You got your Honeycrisp, your Gala. Yeah. Your
beyond that though, like what makes
Red Delicious, your Jonathan, your
Pink Lady.
Can we just say real quick, just
Cosmic. It's apple flavored. It's always that.
Can we talk?
I want a Honeycrisp apple.
Yeah, Honeycrisp is the best.
It is. Correct.
Red Delicious is garbage.
Correct. Okay. Well, Red Delicious and Jonathan like are like for apple pies.
In an apple.
I don't know if I've ever really noticed.
It's like, hey, I want
an apple.
When you go Red Delicious, it's like, hey, I want an apple, but I want it to be mushy. No.
And also covered in like the thickest, like wrapping paper skin. It's like gross. Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Well, cool. No, Honeycrisp is top tier. Like if we were to do a tier list of apples, that would be God tier.
So one time I think I was in like second grade.
The Apple Boys would be on the bottom tier.
One time in second or third grade, my art teacher was like retiring and he was a mean old fart. And we like, the teacher was like, everyone bring him an apple. She was an old school teacher. So we like, you know, bring whatever. And I was like, Mom, I hate this guy. Let's go get him a shitty apple. Verbatim is what I told my mother when I was nine. And so I got him a Red Delicious, and I was like, he's going to hate it.
Good. He I hope he did that. Red Delicious, more like red garbage. Well, this has been Apple Talk with the CineBoiz. Well, guys,
hard hitting stuff.
Really
can't get
hard,
anywhere else.
Really hard hitting stuff. Well, guys, I'm pissed off. I'm just mad.
I'm upset.
I'm real mad today, and here's why I'm mad today. Hollywood keeps making Transformers movies. Like, why?
Michael Bay's not even doing them anymore, right?
I know.
No.
That's like the kind of the reason I would maybe see another one, just to be like, oh, Michael
Bay. Well, I'm pretty sure that not a single, only, I think Bumblebee is the only Transformers movie with a good Rotten Tomatoes score, and I haven't seen it. I don't care. Transformers Rise of the Beast currently sitting at a 53% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Seems too high.
Like, how many are there? Is this the seventh one or something like that? Six or seven?
I think there was four plus Bumblebee, right?
So this is six.
So
we're on to our three third plus Bumblebee. We're on to our third lead actor in the series.
I think the original was a trilogy, then they made Bumblebee. So I think
because it was Shia, Mark Wahlberg, and now you've got Anthony Ramos.
Yeah, I think Shia did two, Mark did one. Haley Steinfeld did one, so that's four. Now we're
but that Bumblebee was kind of like its own thing.
Okay, I actually watched Bumblebee, and it wasn't the worst thing.
So Bumblebee has like a 90-something percent on Rotten Tomatoes. It's like
yeah, it's too high. Only... That was one of those things where it's like it didn't suck, so all the critics were like, "Oh, okay."
I feel like Bumblebee's not your typical like it's a Transformer movie, right? But it's not.
It was just typical... the only Transformer was basically just Bumblebee, so right. It was fine.
It was more like a Herbie movie just with Transformers.
It was Herbie fully loaded plus a little extra mustard.
Yeah. Okay, gotcha. Well, look, here's the bottom line.
Because Bumblebee's yellow.
Yeah, right. Nice.
Here's the bottom line. Hollywood, we do not want these movies. Please stop making them.
But people are going to see it, which is the crazy
It's got part. A 90 yeah, audience score. Audience,
yeah. So why? People want it.
Who's seeing these movies? If you're listening to this podcast and you're a fan of Transformers, please like reach out to us because we need to. You need to explain it to us because it's not good.
Like I remember going to see the very first one in theaters, and it's just like, oh, this was actually pretty enjoyable. Like for one movie for the summer blockbuster, I had a good time. But you know, I've seen it since, and it's not a great movie, but
also,
I see the appeal.
What were we in high school or college?
Oh, we were definitely in high school.
Making more.
I was in. I think it was my the summer of my summer after senior year of high school for me.
Yeah. So we were, and it had Megan Fox, and we were all really like into her at that point. So you know.
Well, no, we didn't know it until we saw it.
Yeah, I remember seeing the first one, being like, "More Megan Fox, please!" Then I saw the second one, and I was like. Less Megan Fox,
no
please.
No more Megan Fox.
I don't trust high school Ken when it comes to movies because
anything.
I saw Beowulf opening night. Like,
right?
You remember that piece of shit?
Yeah, that's my point.
I saw that opening
in high school. You do stuff you like just, that.
Yeah. So of course that
guys,
movie
it'd be so
comes
funny
out
if we went to see Beowulf opening night. Like, how hilarious would it be?
There was like six people there.
And then really, you actually
oh, God, to Beowulf it. Opening night. Sign me up.
Animated, yes please.
And you know, so yeah, of course you're in high school, of course a movie like Transformers is gonna be like, yeah, let's get like eight friends to go to the theater together. Okay, that's another thing, you get like a group of 10 people to go to a movie.
Yeah,
like now I go to the movie by myself pretty much every time I go,
and even if I wanted to try to get that many people to go with me, it'd be impossible,
right? I don't have two friends to rub together to make
a third. Tom, what's the like maximum number of people that we could get to go to a movie? You and me makes two.
Yeah.
So we could maybe get two more if
I
on a good day.
We could get like Jordan and Andy.
Here's a real question for you guys.
A solid foursome.
Here's a real, real good question. You guys live in the same town, pretty close to each other, like a few streets away.
Mm-hmm. I could probably throw a football like six times.
You do a movie podcast together. How often do you go to the theater together?
Never.
Never.
Do you ever talk about maybe going to see a movie together?
We have, and then we just never do.
Got it. Okay.
We have.
Good to know.
Here's the thing.
Kind of bringing it back to Transformers. So we decided this week that we were going to do our part to see if we can get these movies to stop being made. So we're boycotting the theater. Well, let me clear this up. If you go to the movie theater this weekend, go see Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Highly recommend it. It's fantastic. Might go see it again today myself. So go see that. But don't see Transformers. And if you've already seen Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse and you're like, but I really want to watch a movie this weekend, we got four suggestions for you for movies that you can watch at home. And so our recommendation is go see these movies before you go see Transformers. Just don't see Transformers, and maybe they'll stop making Transformers movies. So with that being said, we each have one suggestion. So I'm going to start with Tom. Tom, go for it.
All right. I'm going to recommend that instead of going to the theater, you just stay home, hunker down on the couch, and you turn on Air. Saw it in theaters a couple months ago. Such a good movie. And I can guarantee you right now, it is going to be way better of a time than any Transformers movie.
Yeah. It's a, what is it called? A finance bro movie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Those are big right now. Those are coming.
But I would also say, you know, when I was walking away from it, I was thinking it was very reminiscent of like Moneyball, where it's not so much about like the action of like the sport itself as much as it is just like the background stories that I think are really interesting.
I felt like it was just like, you could tell it was just a bunch of buddies coming together, making a movie about a subject that they were interested in.
Yeah.
And it was enjoyable.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the trailer on the screen here. Oh, there we go. Got it. Done. Yeah. So check out. It's on Amazon Prime, right? It's free.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So highly recommend that. We our review of it is up from a few months ago. Here's how I feel about it. It was just kind of like one of the best mediocre movies I've ever seen. I know that sounds kind of harsh, but I mean that.
No, I agree with that. I agree with that.
Because
there's nothing wrong with that though.
No, absolutely not.
It's a perfect Saturday afternoon movie.
Oh, it's great.
We had a great time.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
Yeah. Highly, highly recommend Air. You can check it on Amazon Prime. So if you don't have an account, steal your parents.
In my comparison to Moneyball, I'm not saying it's as good as
Moneyball. No.
Think of Moneyball and kind of a little bit of
Big Short.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
No. We're in those ballparks.
We're for sure in the corporate, coming of it. I don't know. What would you call that? Just this story of how corporations, we got Tetris. The Hot Cheetos movie, Tetris, BlackBerry. We're getting another one at some point. Anyone seen BlackBerry, by the way?
Yes, I have. Love it.
Heard good things.
I believe I gave it 4.5 stars or 4.5 Swedish fish. So not quite 5.
We're getting the Madden movie.
Dude. Oh yeah.
That's what it
Will Ferrell is John Madden.
I'd see that.
Yeah, I'll see it honestly just because I want to see Will Ferrell's Madden.
Right.
Yeah.
But like, why wouldn't they get Frank Caliendo to be Madden?
I mean, that kind of makes more sense.
Yeah. Apparently Madden hated
Caliendo.
Well, also, like, I feel like Will Ferrell is like an actually good actor, where Frank Caliendo, his only thing is impressions.
He's a
bit guy.
That's true.
Yeah, he's just a bit guy. That's all he is. You heard it here, Caliendo.
Classic
calling. Everyone likes it.
You're a bit guy.
Come on the pod, defend yourself. Dare you?
Yeah. Well, cool, Tom. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that. Let's go on to Mob. Mob, what is your suggestion? Your streaming suggestion, if you will. It actually doesn't have to be streaming. Yeah. You can go rent it.
Well, it is new to streaming, actually.
Okay.
As of a couple days ago, and I struggled with this just because of different things that have happened. But I realized, you know what? The movie's so good. Like, it's so good. It's Creed 3. It's on Amazon Prime right now.
It is.
Yeah. Yep.
It just, I think like a couple recently, days ago.
Yeah.
And
like, if you haven't seen the other Creed movies, go watch them and then watch this one. So you've got a whole weekend of just wonderful boxing movies.
It's Prime, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Prime has some sort of deal where they make their Prime movies and then they can just come to streaming pretty fast.
Well, they own MGM now. So MGM is the company that has the rights to make Rocky movies, essentially, and Amazon bought MGM. So
that's why
you'll get movies like this on Prime. I believe that Air is just Amazon Studios.
That's just Amazon Studios. So,
yeah.
Do we think that's the future of, like, just, I don't know, a movie comes to theaters? How long was Air in theaters before it went to Amazon? Like
six weeks.
6 weeks. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you get 4-6 weeks for people that want to see it in theaters, and then it's just immediately on streaming.
Yeah.
I think so.
While it's still hot. Because otherwise, yeah. I don't know who's going to be. You kind of lose all your momentum if you go to theaters and then you have to wait. What is it? Like 6 months? Eight months? Yeah. A year?
How long is Killers of the Flower Moon going to get for a theatrical run with being Apple TV?
I don't think it's going to get. And then, does it get an initial theatrical run?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because if you watch the trailer, it says in theaters October. So yeah, my guess is it's going to be like 2 weeks. You're going to have 2 week theater exclusive, which is funny for Scorsese, who's so against streaming.
Yeah. God damn, dude. I can't wait for that movie. It looks so good.
I but I honestly might just wait till streaming.
I mean, I probably will too.
It's so long that it's like I'd rather be on my couch.
Right. I think that's one that I'll probably wait to watch it. I don't know. We'll see. I mean, either way, it'll be great. I'm excited. So. Well, cool. Mob, thank you so much. Check out Creed 3. And then Kevin, what do you got? What do you? How are you going to keep people out of the theater from seeing Transformers this weekend?
That's a good question, Kenny. I'm actually going to go with a trilogy of movies, and it's the extended editions of Lord of the Rings. They're all nice. on Max. We've probably all seen them a billion times at this point, but it's one of those movies that I probably watch all three of them like in one weekend or two over the course of two or three weekends, maybe once a year, just because first of all, they're so long. You watch one and you're like, it's one of those movies where for me personally, I watch Fellowship of the Ring and it's like, okay, I kind of have to watch Two Towers like as soon as I can.
Yeah.
And then once you watch Two Towers, like, well, okay, obviously I got to finish this out. I can't not, you know, see the end. And so I have all three in my queue right now. I'm waiting for a slow weekend where I can watch the first and maybe the second. They still hold up.
Yeah.
How long? I think it's been 20 years.
Yep.
Yeah. It's been 20 years since the third movie came out.
Yeah.
Wow. So it's been 22 years since.
Did the first one come out in 2000?
2001.
Okay.
Yeah. It's it used to be a once a year thing for me where I'd sit down and watch all of them.
It's maybe not once a year, but it's at least every other year.
I think it's once every 4 years. It's like the Olympics. And
that's smart.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. Like every time I watch it, though, I'm blown away. It's not that I forget how good it is. It's just that like after all this time, to me, like if we're gonna talk like movie franchises, Star Wars is probably number one for me. But like if you're gonna just talk about quality. Over time, dude, I don't think you can beat Lord of the Rings.
The fact that it still looks good this long after the fact.
It's because they made the conscious decision to not use as much CGI. Like there's some things they had to use CGI on.
Sure.
But like all the orcs and all that stuff is real. And so that's going to hold up.
Yeah, the only CGI shots are like the big aerial views of the giant armies. That's basically it.
And like those big ogres are CGI. Because like you can't, but...
So there is one scene
even those don't look bad.
No.
There's one scene in Return of the King towards the end where Frodo is running away from Gollum into Mount Doom that I can picture where so he's like running into the mountain and they very clearly have Frodo running like or Elijah Wood running like 10 feet, but in reality in the movie he's running like 50 yards and you can see his just like moving abnormally fast. And that's really the only thing I can think of like, whoa, that looks kind of shady. Everything else though.
There's one point where I think it's either one of the characters, Legolas or Aragorn, does this cool thing where they get up. I think it's Legolas where they get up on the horse.
Yeah.
And it's very CGI.
Yeah. Yeah. I know exactly
but
what you're talking
in
about.
In 2003,
it looked awesome.
It was great.
In 2003, I was like, my.
But I'm not going to hold that against you.
And do you know what's funny about it is they didn't, I mean, if this was made today, they would probably marvelize it and inject it with needless humor.
They will, because they're going to be making more of them.
But the one thing that they did that still holds up, basically the only funny thing they did in the entire franchise, Gimli's a little bit of comic relief, and the competition that Gimli and Legolas have of who can get more kills on the battlefield was hilarious in the time. It's a little thing. It's not over the top. And Gimli's like, that only counts as one. Like, good for you. I mean, they just made all the right choices. And every potential spot where you could go left and they went right, it was the right choice to make.
And then they got all their bad choices out with The Hobbit. So
Right.
And so those are also on Max. I would say if you watch those, nothing I can do for you.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Cool. Well, yeah, check it out. It's a good way to spend a weekend, and it's a good way to keep you out of the theater from seeing
Honestly, it's a good way to spend like two or three weekends.
Yeah, that's true. All right, cool. Well, I got one suggestion. It's kind of in the same vein, also on Max, and it's just one that, like, it's pretty recent, and I love it. Sequel's coming out later this year. Dune. You can check out Dune on Max.
It's about time I rewatched that, I think.
Same.
So I'm actually going back through the book now, because the book is, like, super dense, and it's, man, it baffles me that somebody was able to make a movie that good from that source material, because it is... A lot in
Has
there.
Anyone seen the original Dune movie?
Yes, I have. It is.
Is it as bad as I think it is?
God. Actually, you know what? I'm actually going to suggest that. I'm going to suggest.
It's so bad, right, it's like good.
Yeah.
I'm going to suggest the 1984 Dune.
Okay, let's hold up. Let's watch the Denis Villeneuve version first. Right? So you can have a. Because if you watch that bad one first, you're like, I don't even know if I want to watch the second one.
Yeah, no, watch Denis first, because you'll actually have a good time. And then if you have, like, I don't even think the original Dune, like, 84 is 2 hours long. Like, it's not that long. And they try to make
probably moves the so entire, fast.
They try to do the whole book. And it is, it makes no sense.
Yeah.
And I know people, here's the thing, I know people that love 84 Dune, and I don't get it at all. It's kind of gross. The story doesn't make any sense. There's a lot of, like, exposition that they do that is, like, inner monologue, like the voice inside your head. So it sounds like people whispering. It's like, the spies. The spies. There's that great South Park episode where they make fun of it. But, yeah, it's rough.
It's got a 2-hour, 17-minute runtime.
Okay, so... It's a little over 2 hours, but, like, it feels really short for the amount of story that they're trying to tell. And it just falls flat. Just so
It's
flat.
On Netflix.
It is. It's on Netflix?
Yeah.
Yes. It's on Netflix.
I believe it's on Max too.
It is not.
Okay. It was on Max for a while, but.
Yeah. They, you know, they float between all those streaming services.
Here's what
I
will.
That's my old man yelling at a cloud moment right now. Is things move around too much. I can't keep track of where they are. It drives me nuts.
Agreed. And then I will say this. The only thing that I will give 84 Dune is it is so 80s vibey.
Yeah.
Like, it's just pure 80s cinema. So that's kind of fun.
A lot of times I think if I could live in a decade, I would love to live in the early 80s. Mm-hmm. But then I think about, I would have to, like, those would be the movies available for me to see and be like, oh, God, I actually don't know if I could do it.
But here's the thing, dude.
I don't know if I could consume any media.
You wouldn't have what we have now to compare it to. So you probably would
not. No. See, I would. I would be going back with my knowledge of who I am. That's the trick.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
In the 80s, then it's like you don't appreciate the time.
Got it. So you're in this scenario, you have seen the future.
And unplug.
Okay.
And probably realize how bad it was.
Yeah. So that's my suggestion. Check out Denny's 2021 Dune, and then go watch 84 Dune and just be like, what the fuck am I watching? Because that was my reaction when I watched it. It's a good movie to take a nap to, also, 84 Dune. So, well, cool. Guys, I feel a little bit better. You know, I'm not as mad as I was when we got into this, because now I feel like we have options. We don't have to go see Transformers this weekend. And so I recommend that if you're listening to our podcast, that you don't either. Stay home,
Agreed.
Watch one of these movies, or go see Across the Spider-Verse. Away. Those are your options. If we find out that you win all Transformers, can we block people from listening? Is that an option?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if we can do that, but we might. We'll look into it at least. But guys, that's pretty much it. I'm glad we got to hang out today. It's been a while since we all
this
got together. Of course we are the CineBoiz podcast, part of the CorkBats podcast network. Of course you can find our stuff on social media at the CineBoiz on Twitter and Instagram. Be sure to also follow CorkBats on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at CorkBats. Check out CorkBats.com. You can read all of our reviews, including our Across the Spider-Verse review. Be sure to check out our Three Big Things episode from earlier this week also. It's really good. And I think that That's it? Oh, merch. Gotta buy a shirt. Don't forget to buy a shirt. Look, it's on the screen now. Corkbats.com/store. Go buy a shirt if you haven't bought a shirt yet. So, guys, you got anything else you need to get off your chest?
I do not.
Okay.
Cool.
Do Barbie and Oppenheimer come out the same day? Same week?
So. Dude, where you been? Where you been?
I couldn't remember if it was the same day.
July 21st. Or same exact day.
Okay, same day.
This is all over the internet. Day. Do you have like internet? Do you use internet?
Do you internet? I do internet sometimes. I just couldn't remember if it was like, if they were separated by like a week.
It's the same exact day.
Because, yeah, I mean, I'm gonna. I'm probably gonna have to do both, right?
I might take the day off. Oh, I should take the day off and just go see them both.
Back to back.
Yeah, go see one for lunch, one for dinner at Alamo. Spend like $100. Yeah.
That's a day.
Okay. Well, I also forgot to say we are a podcast first and foremost. So be sure to follow us wherever you get your podcasts. You know, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and you can also check the VOD of our podcasts on YouTube.com/CorkBats. We're actually shockingly, that's where we get most of our listens now. Pretty crazy, huh? I think our three.
You know,
big...
I'm starting to turn into a YouTube podcast listener, which I don't like about myself, but that's where I'm at.
Yeah,
so
we're very grateful if you listen to the podcast. That's great. But yeah, YouTube, what's up? Shout out YouTube for all of our YouTube followers and viewers. Really appreciate it. But yeah, that's it, guys. I guess I'll see you later.
Maybe.
Late.
Okay.
That sounded ominous.
Maybe. All right.
Oh,
well.
Wait. Yeah. Definitely. Sorry.
Pray for mom. See you guys.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.